Is it not? This is practical. If you are not minding, the chanting will force you to mind upon you. You see? Krishna sound by force. Chanting is so nice. And this is the practical yoga in this age. You cannot meditate. Your mind is so disturbed, you cannot concentrate your mind. Therefore, chant and by sound vibration, it will possibly enter into your mind. Even if you don't want Krishna, Krishna will enter within your mind. By force. This is the easiest process. You don't require to endeavor. Krishna is coming. It is very nice process. This is recommended there for this age. And others also will be benefited. You chant loudly, others who are not accustomed, they will also, at least just like on the street, on the park, they say, Hare Krishna. How they have learned? By hearing this chanting. That's all. Sometimes the children, as soon as they see us, they say, oh, Hare Krishna. In Montreal, the children, when I was walking on the street, and all the children, the shopkeepers, the storekeepers, they say, Hare Krishna. And that's all. So we have forced Hare Krishna within the mind. If you practice yoga, meditate, it may be beneficial for you, but this is beneficial for many others. Suppose something very good you are enjoying yourself, some sweet balls. That is one stage. But if you distribute sweet balls, that is another stage. So by chanting on the road, on the street, you are distributing sweet balls. You are not miser that you are eating yourself. You are a soul liver that you are distributing to others. Now chant, distribute.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,